challenge the strong. The storm is coming, it grows on the waves. From Johannesburg to Montego Bay, what's that music? Playing on the radio. What's that music? We resist in the present for those who are yet unborn. Our freedom is spreading its wing like a bird, and the message it carries has got to be heard. Oh, what's that music? Ooh, I'm playing everywhere I go. The storm is coming, it grows on the waves. From Johannesburg to Montego Bay, what's that music? Playing on the radio. What's that music?
Throw no apple core, grandma's hands. run with mother. Grandma's hands used to ache sometimes and swell. Grandma's hands, well, it really came in handy. She said, Bobby, why you whip that boy? What you wanna whip him for? He didn't throw no apple core, but I don't have grandma anymore. When I get to heaven, I'll look for grandma's hands. Yeah, keep on calling to me. Yeah, yeah, keep on calling, say yeah. Yeah, they keep on calling to me.
What it has, well, smell of my lady's love, her body blending with my own. The time when the world is dark and quiet and we're alone. The precipice that separates noise from peace. A hint of the ever-evolving magic. A precious place combines and still confirms the space of oneness and togetherness. There's a morning. And still a softer morning in March, a gift for me from God with a darling face and Papa's eyes and Grandma's grace. How there the light of immortality shines as wondrous fragile dream tastes light in the slightest breeze for the first time. Morning thoughts then evolve as smiles and love and sunshine. Lightning flashing through the dawning sky of Grandma's hands and younger days of life. Discovery from behind the veil of her guidance, or the music that forms our historical biography, describing the precious heritage of the aches and frustrations of city life blues, the threats of violence that provide the atmosphere, and observations from the balcony of a B-movie as all the world's a stage. Sunshine on Zimbabwe, shine down on Nicaragua, Liberia, on Poland. Wherever a man would dare stand up for change. We were born at midnight in the darkest time, but surely the first minute of a new day brings new strength.
Together and express.
shots and blame it on the have-nots. Money, we made it. Yeah, but before we see it, they take it. Yes, to make you wanna holler right on home. The way they do your life, make you wanna holler right on home. The way they do your life. Inflation means there ain't no chance and to increase a little bit of finance. And bills they gonna pile up the sky to send that boy off to die. Yes, to make you wanna holler at home. The way they do your life, make you wanna holler at home. Hang-ups and let-downs and bad breaks and setbacks, the natural fact is, oh baby, that I can't pay for no taxes. Yes, it make me wanna holler sometimes and throw up both my hands. It make me wanna holler sometimes.
So you say you never heard of the inner city blues, and what's more, you don't understand at all what the ghetto people mean when they say living behind walls. Well then put on your best suit, white shirt and tie, and run on downtown to stand in line for a job washing dishes that you may not qualify. Walk a big hole in a brand new pair of shoes, and you've had your first look at the inner city blues. Go looking for a place to live, but all the while remember what lurks behind the devil's smile. Are we stupid or just naive that we continue to believe money can buy us anything, including a slice of the American dream? Yeah, answer ads in the paper about houses for sale and get treated like Charles Manson out on bail. When you start to get frustrated by the tactics they use, you'll recognize the feeling. It's the inner city blues. Yeah, make you want to holler sometimes and throw up both your hands. And haven't you ever wondered about why some brothers and sisters were down and out, receiving their sympathy from a bottle of wine, or worse yet, old homicide, living their lives in a glassine bag, or praising the mysteries of Terminal Skag? Some of our brothers parading in drag, another set of victims too whipped to choose. Yeah, you can recognize that, that's the inner city blues. Makes you wanna holler sometimes and throw up both your hands. To see sweet sisters, the blossoms of our African tree, profiling on the corner, talking about 10 and 3. Because in spite of all the money we made and taxes we paid, the woman was looking at hungry babes and some decisions had to be made. Could you tell her it's better to go to your grave as a slave at the minimum wage? Well, I hardly think so, but make you wanna holler sometimes and throw up both your hands. And what happens when people start to feel they have nothing to lose, 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 nothing to lose? Did you ever hear about Mark Essex and the things that made him choose to fight the inner city blues? Yeah, Essex took to the rooftops guerrilla style and watched while all the crackers went wild. Brought in 600 troops, I hear, brand new to see them crushed with fear. Essex fought back with 1,000 rounds, and New Orleans was a changing town, and rat-a-tat-tat-tat-tat-tat was the only sound. Yeah, bring on the stone rifles to knock down walls, bring on the elephant guns, bring on the helicopters to block out the sun. Yeah, made the devil wanna holler, cause 8 was dead and 12 was down, and cries for freedom were a brand new sound. New York, Chicago, Frisco, L.A., justice was served and the unjust were afraid. Cause after all the years and all the fears, brothers were alive, the courage found, and spreading them goddamn blues around. Yeah, make you wanna holler black people and hold up both your hands and say liberation.
Crime is increasing and trigger happy policing. Panic is spreading. Make you wanna holler sometimes and throw up both of your hands. Make you wanna holler sometimes. another man nowadays living in the ghetto, where the danger's sure not real. Well, when he's out late at night, if he's got his head on right, well, I lay you 9 to 5, he's walking with steel. Brother man say he's afraid of gangsters, messing with people just for fun. He don't want to be next, he got a family to protect. So just last week he bought himself a gun. Everybody got a pistol, everybody got a 45. And the philosophy seemed to be, at least as near as I can see, when the other folks give up theirs, I give up mine. This is a violent civilization, the civilization where I am. Every channel that I stop on got a different kind of cop on it. Saturday night just ain't that special. Yeah, I got the Constitution on the run. Cause even though we got the right to defend our home, defend our land, got to understand and get it in hand about the gun. Everybody got a pistol, everybody got a 45.
First thing I want to say is, mandate my ass. Because it seems as though we've been convinced that 26% of the registered voters, not even 26% of the American people, but 26% of the registered voters form a mandate or a landslide. 21% voted for Skippy and 3-4% voted for somebody else who might have been running. But oh yeah, I remember. In this year that we have now declared the year from Shogun to Reagan, I remember what I said about Reagan. Minute. Acted like an actor. Hollywood. Acted like a liberal. Acted like General Franco when he acted like governor of California. Then he acted like a Republican. Then he acted like somebody was going to vote for him for president. And now we act like 26% of the registered voters is actually a mandate. We're all actors in this, I suppose. What has happened is that in the last 20 years, America has changed from a producer to a consumer. And all consumers know that when the producer names the tune, the consumer has got to dance. That's the way it is. We used to be a producer. very inflexible at that, and now we are consumers and finding it difficult to understand. Natural resources and minerals will change your world. The Arabs used to be in the third world. They have bought the second world and put a firm down payment on the first one. Controlling your resources will control your world. This country has been surprised by the way the world looks now. They don't know if they want to be Matt Dillon or Bob Dillon. They don't know if they want to be diplomats or continue the same policy of nuclear nightmare diplomacy. John Foster Dulles ain't nothing but the name of an airport now. The idea concerns the fact that this country wants nostalgia. They want to go back as far as they can, even if it's only as far as last week. Not to face now or tomorrow, but to face backwards. And yesterday was the day of our cinema heroes riding to the rescue at the last possible moment. The day of the man in the white hat, or the man on the white horse, or the man who always came to save America at the last moment. Someone always came to save America at the last moment, especially in B-movies. And when America found itself having a hard time facing the future, they looked for people like John Wayne. But since John Wayne was no longer available, they settled for Ronald Reagan. And it has placed us in a situation that we can only look at like a B-movie. Come with us back to those inglorious days when heroes weren't zeros, before fair was square, when the cavalry came straight away and all American men were like Hemingway, to the days of the wondrous B-movie. The producer, underwritten by all the millionaires necessary, will be Casper the Defensive Weinberger. No more animated a choice is available. The director will be Attila the Hague, running around frantically declaring himself in control and in charge. Ultimate realization of the inmates taking over at the asylum. The screenplay will be adapted from the book called Voodoo Economics by George Papadoc Bush. Music by the village people, the very military macho man. A theme song for saber rattling and selling wars door to door. Remember, we're looking for the closest thing we can find to John Wayne. Clichés abound like kangaroos, courtesy of some spaced out Marlon Perkins, a Reagan contemporary. Clichés like itchy trigger finger and tall in the saddle and riding off or on into the sunset. Clichés like get off of my planet by sundown. More so than clichés like he died with his boots on. Marine tough, the man is Bogart tough, the man is Cagney tough, the man is Hollywood tough, the man is cheap steak tough, and Bonzo substantial. The ultimate in synthetic selling, a Madison Avenue masterpiece, a miracle, a cotton candy politician, pesto macho, macho, macho. Put your orders in, America, and quick as Kodak, your leaders duplicate, with the accent being on the dupes. Because all of a sudden we have fallen prey to selective amnesia, remembering what we want to remember and forgetting what we choose to forget. All of a sudden the man who called for a bloodbath on our college campuses is supposed to be Dudley goddamn Do-Right. You go give them liberals hell, Ronnie. That was the mandate to the new Captain Bligh on the new ship of fools. It was doubtlessly based on his chameleon performance in the past as a liberal Democrat, as the head of the Studio Actors Guild. When other celluloid saviors were cringing in terror from McCarthy, Ron stood tall. It goes all the way back from Hollywood to hillbilly, from liberal to libelous, from Bonzo to Birchite or born again. Civil rights, women's rights, gay rights, it's all wrong. Call in the cavalry to disrupt this perception of freedom gone wild. God damn it, first one wants freedom, then the whole damn world wants freedom. Nostalgia, that's what we want. The good old days, when we gave them hell. When the buck stopped somewhere and you could still buy something with it. To a time when movies was in black and white and so was everything else. Even if we go back to the campaign trail, before Six Gun Ron shot off his face and developed hoof and mouth. Before the free press went down before full court press and were reluctant to view the menu because they knew the only thing available was Crow. Lon Chaney, our man of a thousand faces. No match for Ron. Doug Henning does the makeup. Special effects from Grecian Formula 16 and Crazy Glue. Transportation furnished by the David Rockefeller Remote Control Company. Their slogan is, why wait for 1984? You can panic now and avoid the rush. So much for the good news. As Wall Street goes, so goes the nation. And here's a look at the closing numbers. Racism is up, human rights are down. Peace is shaky, war items are hot. The House claims all ties. Jobs are down, money is scarce, and common sense is at an all-time low in heavy trading. Movies were looking better than ever, and now no one is looking because we're starring in a big movie. And we would rather had John Wayne. We would rather had John Wayne. And you don't need to be in a hurry. And you ain't never really got to worry. And you don't need to check on how you feel. Just keep repeating that none of this is real. And if you're sensing that something's wrong, well, just remember that it won't be too long before the director cuts the scene. Yeah.